Hello, this is Pastor Robert May of Holiness House of Prayer. I'd like to welcome you out to services on Sunday at 6 and Thursday at 7. Everyone's welcome to attend. We want to say we love each and every one of you, and may God bless you today.
Amen. Oh, listen. Amen. Brother Starr, we actually had plans. Amen. Earlier today, going out to Brother Gary Ferguson's. Amen. We was planning on going out and being with Brother Ferguson and joining them in service. And then we call Brother back there on the blue shotgun. That's his CB handle. So we call. Amen. We call him Shotgun all the time. He called and amen. He said, "What are you going to do this evening?" I said, "We're going to go out to Brother Gary's." And he said, "Oh." He said, "Well, you want to go to Sara Ann?" I said, "Well, yeah, let's go to Sara Ann." Amen. Let's go and be with them. Amen. Amen. Might have changed locations, but we still came to Gary's, didn't we? Amen. Amen. First time we came, amen, been a couple months ago, and we came up by the high school up there, and I told him whenever we got here, I said, "Lord, if we had went any farther, I believe we'd have journeyed right on into heaven." Amen. Hadn't been over here, but listen, it's about 2.5 hours to get over here, but praise God. Amen. I'm glad for the spirit that I feel in the house tonight. Amen. I'm glad for the anointing of God. I'm glad for the power of God. I'm glad to know, amen, that's people, amen, that still desires the fire of God, that still desires the Holy Ghost, that still desires a move of God. Amen. It's dying in our churches today. Amen. People don't want a move of God like they used to. Anymore, they just rather sit down on their pew, amen, let the pastor try to preach them into heaven, amen. But how many knows tonight, amen, if you want something, you're going to have to do something to get it, amen, because he said a workman is worthier than me. How many knows tonight, amen, God will bless you, amen, but honey, when you stop, amen, honey, he'll continue to bless you a little way, but then after that, amen, he'll cut it off, amen. It just depends on how far you're willing to go. Amen. You got your Bible? Turn with me in the 4th chapter of the book of Hebrews tonight. Amen. And I tell you what, Sister Storm. Amen. Oh, if Gary said in the morning he ain't making a copy, he said, "Well, that's against Scripture. Bible said Hebrews." Amen. Amen. Hebrews chapter 4. Amen. Hebrews chapter 4. Oh, yes. Let us all stand in honor of the reading of God's word tonight, those that are able to stand. Oh, yes. The Bible says in Hebrews 4 and verse 2, it says, "For unto us was the gospel preached as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it." Let us pray. Most kind, gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you, God, for the anointing. I thank you, God, for the power that we felt here tonight, God. I thank you, God, for the songs of Zion. I thank you, Lord, for the move of your spirit, God. I thank you for each and every soul that's in attendance tonight, God. I pray, God, tonight, if there's any here that's lost and undone, if there's any here that's backslidden, if there's any here tonight, God, that has grown cold on you, Father, I pray tonight, God, is God, that they'll come to you, God, while they still have time. God, that I pray, God, that they dedicate and truly get the horns of the altar and get a hold of you and allow the change to come and get a Holy Ghost fire started in them. Lord, I pray tonight, anoint me, God. God, because I know without your anointing, I can do nothing. But Father, I pray tonight, God, is God, that you open every ear. Is God, give a heart to receive. Hide me behind your cross. Touch and move and bless tonight, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. You may be seated tonight, church. As I sit in the house and right after that, oh, then he called and asked if we wanted to go. And I talked to my wife and we're like, "Yeah, we'll go on down." And I messaged Brother Dallas. And, amen. There ain't very many that I know here in the church. Amen. But Dallas came and we got to meet over at Brother Gary Ferguson's one night and he preached there. And we kind of got to talk. I messaged and his wife answered and said, I told her we was coming down and stuff. They said, looking forward to it. A little while later, he messaged again and said,
you'll probably preach tonight. Get ready. And I said, Lord, have mercy. I want to go have church. Amen. And listen, I'm here to tell you tonight, the Bible says to me, it's in season, out of season. You know what my wife said to me? Whenever Brother Gary said that, she said, I ain't right all the way down here to hear your big mouth. Oh, but Lord, I'll tell on her, I'll get that with her when I get home. Amen. But she said, I didn't come down these crooked roads just to hear you. But I'm going to tell you something tonight. As I sit in the house and I begin to pray, and I begin to seek the Lord, because I always believe if you're a man of God and you've been called to preach, you ought to have a word always on your heart. You ought to be willing all the time to be ready to open your mouth and share the gospel. And I begin to pray and God begin to direct me. Amen. That we need to have, amen, this word being mixed with faith. If I was the title of this message tonight, the name of it is, What Are You Going to Do? Because the Bible said that the word of God that was preached unto them didn't profit them, because they didn't mix it with faith. They didn't add faith to it. The church tonight, are you adding a little faith to the things going on in your life? Are you believing God for the promises that He gave unto you? Are you believing tonight that God's able to move in the midst of your situation? Are you believing tonight that He would withhold no good thing from those that love Him? Are you believing tonight that God's able to do exceedingly above and beyond all that we're able to ask or to think? Are we believing the fullness of the gospel tonight? Because I'm here to tell you, honey, with God all things are possible. I'm here to tell you tonight that God's able, honey, to open every Red Sea. He's able to slay every giant. It will add faith. Woo! Oh, glory. But the question was that God laid on my heart is, what are you going to do about it? We sit here in a church tonight, and many of us have lost family members. We sit here in a church tonight, and some of you are bound by sickness. We sit here in a church tonight, and some of you have lost your Holy Ghost fire. We sit here in a church tonight, and some of you are just questioning God. If God really, oh, is putting you through this, I'm here to tell you tonight, buddy, what are you going to do about it? Are you believing God that God's going to move? Are you believing God? Because I'm here to tell you tonight, when you add faith under the word of God, God will move.
Hey, hey,
oh,
that's powerful, brother.
Yes, come on. Oh, listen, that devil will be coming in you. What are you going to do about it? Oh, that devil trying to destroy your family, what are you going to do about it? That devil trying to tear up your finances, what are you going to do about it? The Bible said that He gave us power to tread upon serpents and upon scorpions. Behold, I give you all power over the enemy. But what are you going to do about it? He said He gave you the power.
Right.
Some of us sit back and say, Lord, what are you going to do? Well, He said, what are you going to do about it?
There you go.
Oh, what do you got in your prayer closet? Oh, and begin to break off the roof for somebody. What do you got in your prayer closet? Believe in God, going to give a healing. What do you got in your prayer closet? Believe in God, going to touch for a miracle that you sought God for the past 4 years. What are you going to do about it? Oh, the Bible said,
preach it, brother.
Oh, listen tonight. The Bible said that there was one child, amen, that from birth, oh, oftentimes he would cast himself into the water, and oftentimes he'd cast himself into the fire. And they brought him unto the disciples, but the disciples could not cure him. But they brought him unto Jesus, and Jesus cast that foul devil out of that child. And the disciples said, why could we not do it? And Jesus said, let me have faith as a grain of mustard seed, that you can say, henceforth, to that mountain, to be thou removed and cast into the devil's sea. Oh, listen, if you have faith tonight and you believe the word of God, he'll listen, the mountain shall move.
Woo! Come on, buddy.
Preach. But what do you do if you have faith and the mountain don't move? You know, Jesus told the disciples, because when He sent them out by 70, they came back rejoicing because spirits were subject to them.
Yeah,
but what happens when you get a hold of a devil that you just can't get rid of? Oh, come on tonight. What happens when you get into a situation, amen, and just your faith ain't enough to do it? Just your faith ain't enough to move the mountain. But the Bible said that only some come by prayer with glory. Somebody ought to shout now. Oh, and fasting. Because tonight, if you're going to do something about it, God's going to move. But here's the key. What are you going to do about it? You're sitting here having a situation at work, getting ready to lose everything at home. But what are you going to do about it? Oh, come on tonight. What are you going to do? We expect Jesus just to do everything.
Right. Preach it, buddy. Come on.
If any man should not work, neither shall he eat. Oh, come on tonight. You know what's happened to the church, Brother Starr? Hey, amen. We've got a lazy bunch of Christians that think that we can just pop this religion in a microwave and 5 minutes later, honey, we've got something to eat. I'm here to tell you tonight, honey, you're going to have to labor in your prayer closet. You're going to have to labor, honey, on your knees. You're going to have to labor pushing your plate back. Labor in your word. Labor in the church.
Come on, preacher. Talk to us, Lord. Talk to us, Lord.
Oh, the Bible says that Paul, amen, in the 16th chapter of the book of Acts, as he was spreading the gospel, there was a woman possessed by a devil of divination. Oh, she made her master as much money as soothsaying. But the Bible said, amen, that she would go around and say, this is one of them of the Lord. Right. This is one of them called by God, basically, out of prayer praise of him. But honey, Paul got fed up with that devil. When you get fed up with that devil, and you put that devil on the run, just like Paul did, he turned around and he rebuked that devil. I need to tell you tonight, if some of us would learn to submit ourselves unto God and resist the devil, he will flee.
There you go.
Oh, listen.
Help us, Lord.
But see, tonight, the Bible says, for unto them, or unto us, was the gospel preached.
Yes.
As well as unto them.
Right.
Oh, see, some of us sit back and they say, why has Brother Gary Starr got so much of a great anointing, but I don't have it, God? Oh, come on tonight. Why is it that sister of so-and-so, oh, she's got the Spirit of God on her so strong? Oh, but why don't I, God? Honey, sit back and examine all night. Amen. How much did they labor to get that anointing? How much time they spent in the prayer closet to get that anointing? How much time have they studied? How much time have they been in the house of God? Some of you ain't seen God move, but you're unfaithful to the house of God. Oh, listen. When you come to church, let me ask you a question. Come here, Brother Starr. When you come to church, you have to look and say, Brother Dad, is Brother Starr going to be here tonight? Oh. So why should he have to turn around and say, Brother Dallas, is your wife coming tonight? Oh, come on. Why should he have to look and say, oh, because let me tell you something here tonight. In Bible study, we've been teaching about the faithfulness of God, and God is faithful. But I'm here to tell you, without your faithfulness, you'll never see the faithfulness of God. Without your faithfulness, you'll never see the hand of God begin to move. Because he said, if you've been faithful over a few things, I'll make you ruler over any. But what are you going to do about it?
That's powerful.
You sit back. You watch everybody else get their blessing. Well, I'm going to tell you something tonight. I sit right there. Lord, begin to deal with me.
Come on, buddy.
While Sister Starr was the same, and on in my car, I want to jump out of my seat and I want to run. I felt the power of God. And listen, I ain't running like that. It's been a long time. But I'm here to tell you something. As I was standing there, the Spirit began to speak to me. And the Bible said, not only in 1 Timothy, but also in 2 Timothy, he said to stir up the gift
Yeah.
which is in you. You want to know why some of you dried up? You want to know why some of you lost your fire? You want to know why some of you ain't seeing the hand of God move on you like you used to? Because you ain't getting stirred up. You're not allowing the Holy Ghost to begin to move on you like you used to. I said, Lord, stir that anointing up in me again. I need a steering. Some of us, we need a steering. But then what are we going to do about it? Oh, come on tonight. We got lost love, but what are we going to do about it?
And preaching it, brother.
Oh, come on. We see there's some areas in the church that's slacking. But what are we going to do about it?
Right.
Oh, listen. I'm preaching to somebody now.
You better believe you are.
Oh, what are we going to do about it tonight, church? Amen. We can lay back and we can watch our church die. We can lay back and we can watch ourselves spiritually die. We can lay back and not see our family saved. We can lay back and watch people miss out on their healing. But when somebody will stand up and say, I want to see the hand of God move. Well, I must have brought an axe and everybody's toes is in the way.
That's all right. You're doing good, buddy. You're preaching good. Preach on, buddy.
Because what are we going to do about it?
Yeah, hands right, buddy.
Amen. Some of you, amen, are sitting so stubborn in your way, you're going to hell. But what are you going to do about it? Woo! Some of you are so stubborn, you've been in me so long, I don't have to read as much as I used to. Oh, they know that I'm getting old in body. I just can't make it to church every day like I used to. Oh, God knows these old knees don't work like they used to. Oh, but you can see, amen, the spiritual change that is in your life. But what are you going to do about it? I'm here to tell you tonight, there have been many times I've not been like coming to the house of God. But when I did, but that little Holy Ghost begin to take over, but what are you going to do about it?
Yeah.
Some of you are sitting in here and been studying, but ain't been getting no new revelation. What are you going to do about it?
Come on.
Oh, come on now.
Yeah, good.
Somebody has been sitting here, been called to preach. Amen. Been preaching the same message every time you got up. Oh, one thing kills me is a rerun preacher. Amen. Let me tell you something. Amen. Leftovers is good ever now and then. But I'm here to tell you, amen, you ought to seek the Lord for fresh bread. You ought to seek the Lord for a new word. You ought to seek the Lord while it's time, while you've got the ability. Because I'm here to tell you that God's word ain't going to do nothing for nobody.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. I'm here to get up. Watch them get up in my own church. Every time they get up, it's the same thing every time. Over and over and over. Over and over and over.
Yep.
And I said, Lord, I know there's more in the Bible than Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. I know there's more in the Bible than Daniel and the lion's den. Oh, somebody help me. I'm a preacher,
Lord.
I know there's more than Moses in the Red Sea.
Come on, buddy. Kill him. That's good.
Oh, tell me about the time of Gideon. Tell me about the time of Rahab. Tell me about Moses when he was up on the mountain and Joshua was over in battle. But glory to God, there was somebody there with Moses on the mountain seeing that he was getting tired and was willing to help lift up his hands. See, when you see your pastor and he's having a rough time, or you see your neighbor and they're having a rough time, what are you going to do about it? Oh, listen, Aaron and Hur was right there. They'd watch his hands begin to fall. Oh, those hands would fall. Joshua began to lose the battle. Some of you is losing the battle because you lost your praise. But what are you going to do about it? Oh, come on tonight.
Preach it, buddy.
There Moses was with his hands down and Joshua defeated.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
Preach it, buddy. It's awesome.
You see somebody over here And you know they're struggling. You know they're having hardship. And they're dying. Come on, brother. And they're dying spiritually. Honey, you grab a hold of them out of that pew. You say, you turn around here, son. We're going to use a little oil. We're going to get that anointing. And we're going to believe in a spiritual shaking, a spiritual awakening, the power of the Holy Ghost that's going to move. Oh, and we believe God's going to do it. God is not a man that he should lie.
Right.
Nor the son of man that he should repent.
Nope.
But you see, the word was preached to him. Ain't a doubt in my mind. I got enough confidence in your pastor that you're getting the word preached to you.
Amen.
Ain't a doubt in my mind. Amen. That he ain't trying to lay down the chalk line for you to walk. Come on tonight. But here's the problem. It ain't that he ain't doing his job. It's that you ain't doing your job. Now what are you going to do about it? Oh, come on tonight. This ain't very popular preaching, but I'm here to tell you. Amen, it's the truth. Amen. We want to see these pews filled. Boy, am I ever so glad. Somebody ought to look. You want to know why you see more talent in the church than what they used to be? Go down through here. Look on these pews. Somebody was doing something about it. There's a little anointing oil on every one of these pews that somebody has decided that they're going to begin to pray. Somebody has decided that they want to see these pews filled. Somebody has decided that they're going to take a stand. They begin to mix the word with faith. They begin to believe God, that God is going to move. But when are we going to believe it for ourselves?
Yeah.
When are we going to believe it for ourselves? When are we, see, faith is an action word. The Bible says that faith without works is dead. Yeah. Even as the body is without the spirit. Can a man say that he had faith without works? Amen. You can say it. You can say, I love Jesus all I want, but if you don't come to church, you're showing you don't love Jesus. Oh, come on tonight. You can say that you're called to preach, but if you ain't in your Bible, and if you ain't sacrificed yourself, offered yourself, if you ain't believed God, amen, I'm going to tell you something tonight. You can say all you want, but he said, well, that desires, but the sight of these people, they draw nigh to me with their lips, but their heart is far from. But tonight, what are you going to do about it? There's some of you in here tonight, you need God to move in a situation. You need God to heal. You need the deliverance of God. Whether it be spiritually, physically, or emotionally, you need the hand of God to touch. But tonight, what are you going to do about it? Some of you lost that fire. Used to have a shout. Used to really run. Used to get up, amen, and let the power of God overtake you and let those Holy Ghost tears begin to fly and didn't care who was around you and allow the tongues of God to begin to blow through you. The word of the Holy Ghost would edify you or listen, would use you to edify somebody else. But what happened to you? The Bible says that in Exodus that the fire on the altar shall never go out. I've learned that when I need that fire back, I need to find my altar. I need to get on there on my knees. Oh, I had one lady tell me one time, as an excuse, I can't get on my knees. I said, honey, sit on it if you have to. Oh, whatever you have to do to get on that altar, to get the restoration of God that you need in your life, honey, do it. Do whatever it takes. Go as far as it takes to do what it takes to get God. The woman that had the issue of blood, you want to know how she got healed? Because she done something about it. Naaman. Oh, king of Assyria. You want to know how he got healed? Because he done something about it.
Yes.
Oh, he went and he seen Elijah. Amen. He expected some big thing. Some of you's expecting some big thing. Like Brother Gary's going to be back there, grab you by the hand, jerk you up and start all over you, and everything's going to be better. Oh, listen.
I love it.
But God's going to say no. Because the servant told him, said, if he'd asked you to do a hard thing, you'd have done it. But all he asked was that you went down to the river of Jordan and dipped seven times. Honey, God, all he's asking for you is just to be faithful. All God's asking you, amen, is to get it stirred back up in you. All God's asking you is to give in your whole heart that it be found in you. All God's asking you is to believe the word that was preached unto you. And that word, I'm here to tell you, is forever settled in heaven. Honey, that word, honey, will never pass away. He said, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word abides forever. But tonight, what are you going to do about it? Today, some of you sit back knowing that you're spiritually dying. Tonight, knowing that you're going to be facing hell. Knowing that you'll never get the healing that you need. Knowing that you'll never get the revelation. Knowing that you'll never see the hand of God move unless you do something about it. Mama can't do it for you. Daddy can't do it. Your pastor can't do it. The only one that it takes is you. You have to be the one to do it. When you got saved, I'm going to tell you something tonight. Amen. The Bible says that we're saved by grace through faith. Not of ourselves, but it is a gift of God, lest any man should boast. It took that faith to accept grace. You had to believe the word that was preached. The Bible said that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Oh, now preacher, I just ain't got no faith. Biggest lie I've ever heard, every man's met with a measure of faith. If you believe God tonight, if you believe God tonight, he said to come under the throne of grace boldly, that you may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. If you'll stand up and say, God, I'm going to do whatever it takes. If your son asked for a fish, would you give him a serpent? If he asked a loaf of bread, would you give him a stone? He said, you being evil know how to give good gifts unto your children. How much more shall your heavenly Father give good gifts unto those that love him? One part said the Holy Ghost. I'm here to tell you something tonight. If you'll press in tonight, if you'll get your dedication back tonight, if you'll do something about it, God's going to move in the midst of your situation. But tonight, what are you going to do about it?
Yeah, right.
Is it all right if we give it all to God?
I can't believe it, brother. I'm excited.
Tonight, come on, singers, whoever.
Oh, I can start a song.